There ain't nothing in the entire known multiverse that can compare to us. Brand new, fresh, unused. That's the most important part. Urinal cake. Urinal cake. Just saying that word makes me ecstatic, fills me with, I can't even put it into words. Urinal cake. Say it with me, won't you? Urinal cake. Yeah, that's it. Also known as the urinal donut to some entities and individuals. The urinal puck to others. The esteemed toilet lolly to even others. The urinal cookie. Yes, but I must say that as delicious as they smell, here you go. Take a good deep whiff of this fresh, unused urinal cake. Don't try to take a bite. Should never eat these. Well, humans shouldn't. Other species in other dimensions, perhaps. As wonderful as an aroma that urinal cakes, urinal cookies might have, like I said, they're not meant to be eaten. I tried once, and then I died. And then I was reanimated and brought here to wonderful place, Arthur's Sanitarium. Yes, I must sincerely apologize. I don't believe we've met before. My name is Carl. I am the, well, one of the custodians here at Arthur's Sanitarium. I am the eyes and ears of this institution. I have a fleeting, vague recollection that I was the custodian at a high school. I vaguely remember one particular weekend at this high school where I was making my rounds, cleaning, polishing, adding new urinal cakes. Urinal cake. Urinal cake. Urinal cake. Urinal cake. Urinal cake. Urinal cake. When I came upon a group of about four high school students. I think it was four. They were in detention that day. Yeah. Can't remember their names. Oh, yeah. Claire. And Bender. Strange name. I think there were five, not four. But after being reanimated and buried in Marjorie's garden, well, things tend to get a little fuzzy up in the old noggin. But it's nice to meet you. I was just walking down the hall, mopping the floor, when I saw the door open, and you here in that very comfortable, almost dentist office like chair. So I just thought I would drop in and say hello and share with you the most favorite part of my job. Urinal cakes. Just about to replace the ones in the restroom here. These happen to be snozzberry. Unfortunately, unlike snozzberry wallpaper, you can't lick these. Well, you can, but I wouldn't recommend it unless you want to die. You don't want to. do you? No, of course you don't. Although, there are those here at Arthur's Sanitarium who do wish for such a thing, but only to participate in the reanimation project that Professor Corvus runs. But let us not speak any more of such things. Okay, my friend, can I call you that? My friend, even though we just met. I have a feeling we might be seeing each other a little more often. Maybe not as often as we would like, but okay. Well, forgive me for prattling on and on. Would you like to listen to the sounds of these and a few other urinal cakes? Friend. By the way, what's your name? Oh, that is such a wonderful name. Is that your birth name, or did they, one of the doctors here give you that name? Would you happen to be a creation of one of the experiments, one of the many experiments that are run here, or are you as fresh and new to this world, or were, just like a urinal cake? I see. Very good. Let's get back to the sounds of these snozzberry urinal cookies. You know, I'm not really supposed to do this, but I must say I kind of like you. How would you like one of my own urinal cakes, snozz raspberry scented. You would? Okay. Well, since you're strapped to that chair, I'll set it right down on the little table they have here with all their medical instruments. And you can get it later when they release you. Set it right here. Look at all this stuff. Brain. Is this your brain? The unspeakable horrors. It's like looking straight into the abyss. Here, why don't you take a look, see for yourself. What do you see? And here I thought it was just a simple little light. Is the strangest hammer that I've ever seen. Doctors and their strange medical devices. Looks like a toothpick, some kind. Scissors. When I was younger, I think I had a dream where, where I always wanted to be. Force pilot. Testing, testing, testing. So this is how they do it. Do you mind if I listen to your heart? Nice beat. Well, I never thought about being an electrician, but if I did, I probably would have changed that thought and maybe looked into becoming a plumber instead. But I'm glad I never became a pilot or an electrician, because I know the universe wanted me to be a custodian. You know what? Let me show you some of the other urinal cakes. This one is yours. I forgot. Let me put this one into the toilet real quick. I'll be right back. Cherry scented urinal cakes, my sixth best favorite scent. Snozzberry, my second. Chocolate, my first. Pineapple scented urinal cake, my third. And then, well, whatever. Here, one for you. And one for me. You know, if there's one thing I like more than the aroma of a fresh new urinal cake, it's a fresh new urinal cake in an unopened plastic bag. Let's open it up, shall we? A little stubborn. I think this toothpick should do the trick. Quite the sharp toothpick. Oh, the smell of that cherry. Take a whiff, my friend. Let me take it out just a moment. Let me take it out before you smell it. Such a delicious cherry scent. Behold the cherry scented urinal cake. An exquisite marvel of eldritch technology and design. Only an elder god could create such a thing. Thank you. if I open your cherry urinal cake so I can make some sounds of the two of them together. Okay, great. Whew, so powerful. Try inhaling the scent of two at the same time. his office. See what urinal cakes I have next for you. Did I let you take a whiff of the cherry urinal cake? I can't recall. I think I did. Take another whiff. Intoxicate your mind as the little smelly particles permeate your entire being, your very essence. You will become one with the urinal cake. Your entire being will merge in harmony with the urinal cake. You will become the urinal cake, but for a brief moment in time. And if you're lucky, all the dreams, all the life experiences that the urinal cake has experienced, you will experience. And it all takes place with one whiff of the urinal cake. In that moment in time, you will have thoughts and memories and visions of urinal cake society and civilization, of how urinal cakes came to be, of the struggles they are faced with, the great battles that occurred between the various nations, all of it, in that brief moment, you will become one with the urinal cake. Enough prattling. I don't think I showed you close-up look of this raspberry and cherry urinal cakes. Thank you. Snosberry on the right, very similar to the apple on the left. But it takes a custodian with many, many millenniums of experience to distinguish between a snozzberry scented urinal cake and the apple. To the untrained eye, you wouldn't be able to notice. Thank you. one of the apple scented urinal cake and the other, well, I believe this is for Marjorie's urinal. You know Marjorie and her garden. Patients, other staff members love to be buried in Marjorie's garden. And I do on the occasion as well. Buried with urinal cakes all around. Okay, well, we have time for just one more pair of urinal donuts. Although you can't really call them donuts because they have no holes in the middle, but these are strawberry scented urinal cakes. You have one. Let me open the other one. Yours as well. Behold, my friend, the as you have one, I'll let you have yours back just a moment. Are you fast asleep already? It's hard for me to tell, but, well, my new dear Professor Corvus for being a little lax on the job, and I do have thousands upon thousands of urinals that need fresh new urinal cakes. So, if you will pardon me, I must make my leave. But you are now the proud owner. Sanitarium that the entire multiverse has ever known. So enjoy. Do with them as you please, but don't eat them. Okay. Well, it was a pleasure meeting you. And I have a feeling that we'll be seeing each other again. One more whiff before I go. I've never inhaled the scent